Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, I'm Kenny. Make sure you subscribe to my channel, I really appreciate it. In today's video, I'll be doing like a natural hair basic sort of thing. I'll be talking about 4 things I feel every person with natural hair should know about their hair. These are the things that will help you when choosing your product. These are the things that will help you to know how much manipulation your hair can undo. These are the things that will help you to know how to properly moisturize your hair so that your hair is not always dry. And all these things will directly or indirectly reduce hair breakage and facilitate your hair growth, because you are not losing so much hair as you are growing it out. So those are the things I'll be talking about in this video. If you enjoyed this video, please don't forget to give me a thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel. I would really appreciate your thumbs up and also your subscription to my channel. Please make sure you subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. The 4 things I'll be talking about in this video are natural hair porosity, natural hair width or texture, and natural hair density. And the 4th thing I'll be talking about is curl pattern or natural hair type or pattern. So the 1st thing I'll be talking about is natural hair porosity, and I'm talking about this first because I believe it's the most important thing everyone with natural hair should know about their hair first, even before knowing what your curl pattern is, before knowing if your hair is 2A or 3C or 4B or 4C or 4D. The first thing you're supposed to know about your hair is knowing what your natural hair porosity is, because this is what will help you in knowing how to properly moisturize your hair so that your hair is not always dry, and how much moisture your hair can undo, and also how easy it is for your hair to absorb moisture. What natural hair porosity simply means how porous your hair is, how well your hair can easily absorb moisture, and how well it can retain that moisture. And we have high porosity hair, medium porosity, and low porosity. For people with high porosity hair, their hair can easily absorb moisture, but as much as it can easily absorb those moisture, it can also easily lose it. People with low porosity hair, their hair does not easily absorb moisture from anything moisturizing, and also once their hair absorbs that moisture, it does not easily lose it. And people with medium porosity hair, they are not high porous, their hair is not highly porous, it's not low porous, it doesn't have low porosity, it's like straight in the middle. So the simple test to know what your natural hair porosity is by taking a strand of your hair. It's advisable to do this when your hair is clean with no product in it, fresh out of the shower, your hair is clean. Take a strand of it and put it in a cup of water. If your hair goes down to the cup of the water, that means that your hair is highly porous. If it stays on top, like it's floating, that means that your hair is low porous. And if it's in the middle, that means that it's medium porosity. Okay guys, so I want to show you a demo of the hair porosity test. I'll take a strand of my hair and I'll drop it in this cup of water, and I'll wait for like 2-3 minutes and see what it will do. And 2-3 minutes has passed, and this is my hair. As you can see, it's floating on top. Even for the fact that I shook the hair in the water when I dropped it in, it still didn't sink into the cup of the water, it remained on top of it, and that lets me know that I have low porosity test. So you can do this test yourself too and know what porosity your hair is. If it stays on top, like it's floating, that means that you have low porosity. If it goes down to the bottom of the cup, that means that you have high porosity hair. And if it stays in the middle, that means that you have medium porosity hair. And this will let you know how to properly moisturize your hair.
So I've done this test on my hair several times and on every section of my hair. You can also do it on every section of your hair, because hair porosity can vary from one section to another. And I've done this on every section of my hair, and I've also done this test countless times. You can also do it like 2-3 times a year, because natural hair porosity can change, the weather can change it, bleaching your hair can change it, using it on your hair can change it, using heavy chemicals on your hair can change it. So those are the things that can change your hair porosity. I've done this test several times and my hair always floats on top, which makes me know that I have low porosity hair. For people with low porosity, someone like me, I have low porosity hair. When I will take little attention to how I deep condition my hair and also moisturize my hair. When I'm deep conditioning my hair, I always eat my deep conditioner before applying it on my hair, because people with low porosity, the easiest way or the most effective way to help your hair in absorbing moisture you're applying to it is by including it or warmth when moisturizing your hair. I'm not talking about it by using flat iron or using a blow dryer. I'm talking about it like this, like using steam on your hair before moisturizing it to open up the cuticles of your hair so that they are readily opened to soak up the moisture you're applying to it. When I'm doing my deep conditioning, I eat my hair mask, either DIY or stubble. I always eat my ear mask before applying it to my hair. The warmness of the deep conditioner or the warmness of the ear mask will aid my hair in easily absorbing it. When I'm moisturizing my hair, I always spritz my hair with warm water first, which is what I always use as my first liquid before going in with any moisturizer. And also when you have low porosity hair, you want to be careful how you layer your product. You don't want to use thick or heavy butters or heavy cream on your hair. You want to use products that are lightweight that can easily penetrate your hair strands. If you have high porosity hair, you want to look for heavy creams and heavy butters when moisturizing your hair, so that when you use heavy creams and butters in your hair, they can easily fill up those little gaps that are in your hair cuticles. So for people with low porosity hair, our cuticles are tightly close together, and people with high porosity hair, their cuticles are very loosely packed together. I don't know what English to use. They are very loosely packed together. Let me just say it like that. But people with high porosity and low porosity hair, our cuticles are very closely packed together. So for us to ensure that our cuticles just relax a little bit to allow that moisture to enter, to penetrate our hair strands, we have to include it, like moist it when moisturizing, when deep conditioning our hair. And if you have high porosity hair, you want to look for heavy creams and butter. I'll be doing a second part of this video, which I'll be doing my product recommendation for each category which your hair falls into. So you may want to look out for that video, the second part of this video, where I'll be talking about my product recommendation for high porosity hair, low porosity hair, and also every other thing I'll be talking about in this video. And also, when you know your hair porosity, it will let you know how to maintain your moisture protein balance. People with high porosity hair, they need more protein in their hair than us with low porosity hair, because your hair cuticles are already closely packed together. So if you use more protein on your hair, it will further tighten it. So if you are someone with high porosity hair, if they do protein treatment every 2 weeks or every 4 weeks, you with high porosity hair, you want to do your own protein treatment every 3 months or every 2 months or every 6 weeks, so that you are not using too much protein on your hair, because your hair cuticles are already so packed together. So knowing how to maintain your moisture protein balance is also very important. And when you know what your air porosity is, to let you know how much, if your hair need more moisture, if your hair need more protein, and if your hair need lightweight products, if your hair need heavy creams, if your hair needs warmth when moisturizing your hair, or if your hair just need you sealing, using more sealants like cold water, like shea butter, like coconut oil, like JBCO oil, all those heavy sealants. That is what your hair need if you have high porosity hair. So I'm talking fast because I know this video is already gonna be long, so I don't want it to be unnecessarily long. That is why I'm talking so fast, and that is why my points are all over the place, so excuse that. The second thing I'll be talking about is knowing your hair texture or your hair weight. Hair texture simply means how thick or thin each individual strand of your hair is. If your hair is thick, that means that you have coarse hair, and if your hair is thin, that means that you have fine hair, and if your hair is not thick, it's not fine, that means that you have medium texture or medium weight. So, and the simple test to do to know this is that take a simple strand of your hair, which I'm going to do now. I'm going to pull out a strand of my hair, and you can just take it. Oof, I took out two. So, and you can just take these in bright light or in natural light, and you look at your hair. If you can easily see your hair strand, someone like me, even taking it closely or apart, I can easily see my hair strand. That means that my hair is thick. And if you cannot easily see your hair strands, that means that your hair is thin. We have different eyesight, so this may also affect it. You can ask, let other people also check it for you, and I'll tell you another test to do. Another thing is that you can pull your hair. As I'm pulling my hair, it's so it's not so easy from hair to break. As you can see, I'm pulling it apart, and my hair is not even breaking because it's so thick. And people with thin hair, when you try to pull your hair like this, it will easily break. As you can see, my hair does not easily break. Knowing how coarse or how fine your hair is, these are the things that will help you to know how much manipulation your hair can handle. Someone like me, I have thick hair, my hair is coarse, my hair can undo so much manipulation than someone with fine hair. If I go in with a large tooth comb and start combing my hair now, and someone with fine hair does the same thing, I'll have breakage, but my breakage will be minimal compared to someone with fine hair. So that is what knowing your hair width or thickness or your hair texture, that is what it will let you know. So the third thing I'll be talking about is knowing your hair density. And hair density simply means knowing how much hair on all this of my hair, how much hair do I have all over my head. And the simplest way is by counting each strand of our hair. That is simple, and at the same time it's so difficult. But the simplest way to know this, jokes apart, is doing this simple test when your hair is dry, because most of the time when our hair is wet, it's always very floppy and just flat looking. But once your hair is dry, you ask someone to look at every angle of your head, and if they can easily see your scalp, that means that you have low density hair. And if it's not so easy for them to see your scalp, that means that you have high density hair. Someone like me, I have high density hair. When they cannot determine if they can easily or not easily see, or if it's in the middle, that means that you have medium density hair. How this will help you is that it will let you know your style selections, or how to do what type of styles or what type of stylers to use on your hair. People with low density hair, if you are someone with low density hair and you love big hair, when you are doing your wash and goes, you use the shingling method instead of the raking method, because the raking method gives you less volume while the shingling method gives you more volume. So if you have low density hair and you think you want more volume in your hair, you want to use the shingling method when doing your wash and go. When doing your twist out, you want to separate your hair more so that you have more volume. That is if you like more volume in your hair. And also when you are using products on your hair, people with low density hair, you want to use lightweight styler so that it does not easily weigh down your hair. And us with high density hair, we go for butters or thick stylers when styling our hair. So that is what knowing your hair density will let you know, how to do your styles, how to let your styles come out as you have envisioned it. And natural hair density can be affected by your hair thickness. If you have fine hair, you may have low porosity hair, and there are a lot of people that have fine hair and they still have high density hair, and a lot of people that have thick hair and they still have low density hair. So it may affect your hair texture or your hair texture or thickness can affect your hair density, and at the same time it may not matter. If you have thick hair, it does not necessarily mean that you have high density hair, and if you have fine hair, it does not necessarily mean that you have low density hair, but it can still affect it. So you just have to do this simple test so you know what category your hair falls into. And like I said, the most important of all this is knowing your natural hair porosity, because that is what will let you know what type of moisturizer you need on your hair, what type of method you use to moisturize your hair, how much protein or can your hair undo, and also how much moisture can you put in your hair. So those are the things that will let you know those things. And the fourth thing which most people usually want to know first once they go natural is knowing their curl pattern or hair type. And as much as this is important, what knowing your curl pattern or hair type, it's the way it will help you is that it will help you in choosing stylers and also what type of styles to do on your hair. A natural hair curl pattern, it simply means what each individual strand of your hair, what it looks like, the shape of each individual strand of your hair. The most popular way of categorizing natural hair curl pattern is invented by a popular natural hair stylist. His name is Andrew Walker. I'll put it right here on the screen if I don't know how to call it. Andrew Walker is the one that invented it, and he categorized natural hair into four categories. We have the type 1 hair, the type 2 hair, the type 3 hair, and the type 4 hair. The type 1 hair are the straight hair, the type 2 hair are the wavy hair, the type 3 hair are the curly hair, and the type 4 hair are the kinky or coily hair. So as he categorized this hair into these four types, under these types they also have like subtype, which under two we have 2A, 2B, 2C, 3A, 3B, 3C, 4A, 4B, 4C. And I'll leave the chart right here for some minutes so that you can look at it, and also I'll most likely have a blog post on this topic so they can check out that blog post in a bigger picture so that you see which category your core pattern falls into if you are interested in knowing it. And I also put it on my Instagram. If you follow me on Instagram, Kenny_Olapade, I'll put it right here on the screen. Also I'll put the chart right here on the screen so that you see and know what your core pattern falls into.
We lose ourselves.
4B4CA. Most of the people I watch their natural hairstyles are most of the people I watch their natural hairstyle videos are people with 4B4CA. And the reason is that when I do my twist out, I won't envision my twist out coming out like someone with 3CA. So if someone with 3CA is doing a twist out, I'll most likely not watch a twist out because I know that my twist out may not come out like a twister. So and go to someone with 4B4CA and look at a twister so that I'll have like an envision or I'll have like an expectation of how my twist out will come out or my braid out or my wash and go. If someone with 4CA has high porosity hair, I'll most likely know what how she moisturizes her hair because she has high porosity hair. So if she's dishing out advice or tips for people with high porosity hair, although we both have 4CA, it won't help me because I don't have high porosity hair. We both have 4CA, but she has high porosity hair, I have low porosity hair. So I'll look for people with low porosity hair to look for advice or tips or moisturizing tips or how to moisturize low porosity hair videos or posts and all those things. So I'll look for people with low porosity hair and see how they moisturize their hair. And I'll look for people with 4C, 4B hair when I'm looking for how to do my twist out or looking for how to do my braid out or twist out or wash and go. So those are the things, these four things will help you in knowing. When you know your look, your hair porosity, your hair thickness, if you know your hair porosity, your hair texture, your hair density and also your core pattern, they will help you in different ways in knowing how to properly manage and maintain your natural hair so that your hair is not susceptible to constant damage and breakage and all those things. So those are the four things I want to talk about today, and I know this video will be long, so just bear with me and make sure you give me a thumbs up like, and also subscribe to my channel. You can also share this video with your friends, your new natural friends or your old natural friends, that will feel they'll benefit from everything we talk about in this video. And also don't forget to check out my blog post on these four things I just discuss now, because there may be some things I miss out in this video and they'll be in that blog post. And also the core pattern, different core pattern charts and all those things, they will be more detailed in that blog post. And also if you want another video on each of these things, especially natural hair porosity for low porosity hair or 4C core pattern, how to know if your hair is this core pattern, if you want a different video on these things, let me know in the comment section below. And also let me know, what is your natural hair porosity, what is your core pattern, what do you look for in, what is the first thing you look for in your hair when you first go natural, what was the first thing you were so eager to know about your hair, is it your natural hair porosity or is it your core pattern? Because me, the first thing I was so eager to know was my core pattern, but then I started doing some research and I found out that I don't necessarily, the first thing I'm supposed to know is my hair porosity. That is what will help me know how to properly moisturize my hair. And since I've known my hair porosity, my hair does not easily dry out. That is why most of the styles I do, I say my hair is 10 days old or 9 days old or almost 2 weeks old. And people still ask me, and your hair is looking so moisturized after a week or almost, and also close to 2 weeks, and your hair is looking this moisturized. That is because I've known my hair, I've studied my hair, I've done my porosity test, and I've known what type of products work for my hair, how to properly moisturize my hair. So those are the things that have helped me. So guys, like I said, make sure you share this video with people you think would be of benefit, and you can share it on Facebook, you can share it on Twitter, you can share it on Google+, you can WhatsApp it to your friends and all those things. If you like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up like I said, and also leave me comment in the comment section below. If you have any question or anything you want to add to this thing we just discussed right here now, leave it in the comment section below. And please make sure you subscribe to my channel. You can also press that bell beside the subscribe button so you are notified of my new uploads. Anytime I have a new video, you get a notification that, oh, Ken Olapade has got a new video, and you can just rush here and check out my video. Make sure you check out the second part of this video, which will be my product recommendation for each hair type, especially for each hair porosity, my styler recommendation for each core pattern, and also my product recommendation for each hair porosity. So thank you guys, and I'll catch you in my next video. Bye.